division of cost diagrams. You know the definitions of sine, cos, and tan in a right-angle triangle. If I use x for the horizontal displacement, the adjacent there, and y for the vertical displacement, I can write the trig ratios in terms of x and y and r, the hypotenuse. And this can be extended to angles of any magnitude by considering the right-angle triangle to be positioned on coordinate axes. So starting with this case, which is the one I've already considered, where x and y are both positive, sine theta, y over r, is positive, cos theta, x over r, is also positive. They're all positive in that quadrant. Looking now at obtuse angles, that's angles between 90 degrees and 180 degrees, so measuring round from the positive x-axis. Now, when I consider y over r, y is still positive, so sine theta is still positive, but x is negative. X over r will be negative. Cos theta is negative for obtuse angles. In this quarter of the page, sine is the only one that's positive. Going round now to angles between 180 degrees and 270 degrees, reflex angles, x and y are both negative here. Y over r, sine is negative, x over r, cos is negative. The only one here that's positive is tan. Finally, looking at reflex angles which are bigger than 270 degrees, x is now positive again, but y is negative. So cosine, x over r, is positive. Sine, y over r, is negative. The only one that's positive in this quadrant is cosine. You could work it out for yourself each time, or just remember the diagram with CAST, which is why the textbook calls them CAST diagrams.